in here and cut this vertically, see what I'd be taking off? That's why it has to be the strong cut. Fringe area, we don't want to cut that off, so I'm just going to clean this off a bit. We're going to come back in and we'll address this. I'm going to go in and cut out the fringe area. Now, to recap, I started out back here, strong concave, held out to a 90 out here, working. Okay, to recap, started out at the back, at the center parting. Very strong concave, took this out to 90 with my fingers concave, worked my way around the head, and I completed my design side. So this way I've kept all my length, just cleaned it up, and you can see where it's already shattered in here without doing anything to it. No texturizing, no razor, nothing. Okay, I'm going to go to design copy side now. Key point, and the most important point that I can stress here is this first section on the copy side has to be held out to a 90. If not, you're going to end up with the copy side being shorter from my design side. The rest of it, I'm just going to move out of the way. Similar section from the copy side. Clean this out. Move it out the way. Timer, if you would, please. Okay. I'm going to take a piece from my design side, incorporate that with a piece from my copy side. Take it out to the 90. Here's my guide. You see it here? This out to the 90, making sure that my fingers are concave and not vertical. Pulling it up to that 90 and cut. Take the second half of that section. Up to the 90, here's my guide. Fingers are concave, I'm up to a 90, and take that off. then I just move on. Here's my guide, I'm up to 90, fingers are concave, repetitious, piece of the previous, lift to the 90, as clean as you can, makes it easier to see your guides, your partings. Guide. Lifting this up here, it's just coming around, right out off the head. Down here. There's my guide, fingers are concave, matching my parting.